Utawarerumono, Mask of Truth, episode 43. So, as you may hear on my voice, it's a little, like, a little damaged. I can't really do high-pitched tones, because if I do that, it will be... Yeah. That's how bad it is, and I think you can hear that. But you will have to settle with my normal, simple voice for this one. So, yeah, that's it. And I'm sorry for not uploading on Saturday, but... Unfortunately, it came Tuesday, and I had only recorded so that I had enough until Friday, and I had recorded the last on Monday, so I wasn't able to record for Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and Friday, and Saturday, of course. So that's why I record today, because my voice is essentially at that state now where it's working, alright? It's not 100%, but I think it will be like at least... half next week until it will be fully restored, if not the entire week until it's been fully restored, so you will have to live with that voice. But under a sky far removed from Yamato's, a lone figure sits in quiet meditation. Hey, that we have Minutiga. She sits with absolute stillness, eyes closed, her mind empty of nearly all thought. With all mental distraction banished, the Pillar General Munichika sits in serene reflection, examining her own heart and feelings. But her concentration is broken by a charming visitor.
Munichika-sama,
do they have a connection? Interesting. What brings you here? Sensing a presence, Munichika straightens her legs and turns to face the newcomer. The woman smiles gently to Munichika. So has she been, like, well, captured, like, she's not in Yamato, that's all it is, there is, like, she's not in Yamato anymore. Is that it? As your guest, okay? So yeah, she's not in Yamato, then she has to be in Tusker. That's the thing, she has to be in Tusker then. Munichika bows her head solemnly, though Fumiril only tilts her head in confusion. This was Ku's request, yeah? Mere words of gratitude, indeed. I have to be grateful, I have to have respect. Meet with respect and you shall hopefully be met with respect.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
A little longer, yeah, well, why not? Munechika gives a wry smile at Fumiril's apology. This is Tuskur. While Munechika has no details on precisely where she has been placed under house arrest here as a prisoner of war. Yeah. And yet, despite her circumstances, she has been treated with nothing but consideration and respect. A general of the enemy's army and a handful of the soldiers that served her. Under ordinary circumstances, they would have been forced into hard labor or worse. For the most part, though, they have been left to their own devices. Far from being forced into work, they barely have to provide for themselves. As long as they remain close by, they are even permitted to roam freely or visit a nearby village. It's not like any imprisonment Munechika has known. Had she a mind to do so, escape would be extremely easy. Wow. But why would you want to escape, though? Why would you want to escape? you know what? It's no problem. This is kind of this mysterious music that is kind of like that a character has that is kind of sneaky. I just feel like she is, yeah. I don't know why, but Fumiril tilts her head in charming confusion. Okay, well. Which only adds to Minichika's concern. The pillar general sides to herself, examining her hostess. She doesn't see a trace of doubt or hesitation upon Fumidil's face. Perhaps this is simply the way prisoners are treated in Tusker. Yeah, no, it's the Queen's order. Sorry to say, or well, happy to say. Fumidil brightens immediately. Fumiril nods happily with an enchanting smile. She continues rushing over her words in her excitement. A little errand. Is she gonna go to Kuon? Is that it? Munechika blinks in surprise, not fully understanding Fumiril's intention. You are stronger than me, or than most of them. Yeah, but I don't think you have that much intention of serving Yamato anymore, so... Munechika can't imagine imagine where she wants to go, but accompanying her would bring both of them unnecessary trouble, so she thought, at least. Okay. A little secret, yeah. We have secrets enough. But yeah, Fumiril's smile turns a little mischievous, lowering a voice conspiratorially. That would only make it a worse idea to travel with an enemy general, like taking a wounded beast out of a cage with no leash or supervision. If worst comes to worst, Fumiril's very life would be in danger, a very foolish idea. Munechika wants to give a word of warning, but... Just accept it. Fumiril stares at her, eyes full of innocence, and Munechika falters. Somehow Munechika is unable to get the words out to refuse her. She ponders it a moment more and decides that this could be a perfect opportunity to repay her debt. She finally responds with a slow nod. Yay, adventure time! Oh. Fumiril can hardly contain her joy, seizing Munechika's hand in delight. Yeah, I have a feeling they're gonna go to Kuon and the others. And Munechika, like, I really want Munechika to meet Haku, or well, Oster, just to see how she would react to it. That would be pretty cool. Fumiril hums happily, skipping out of the room. Munechika gazes after her, staring at the room's exit, her eyes far away, like a storm just passed over her. Yeah, well, Munichika's mother carries with a certain relief and resignation. Fumiri is truly a beautiful woman, a figure, her demeanor, everything about her is full of charm, almost frighteningly so. The first time Munichika saw her, her beauty made Munichika wonder if the woman was just some fantasy conjured by her mind. But in conversation, she seems more like a puppy or wide-eyed kitten. There's certain helplessness about her that makes one want to protect her. Interesting. Her namesake may be the Moonflower, but it might be better to say she is Munichika's. She is, oh, Munichika thinks, an evening star, the fairest of all stars. Wow. Munichika catches herself smiling and regains her stoic composure. Yeah, well, for as long as she can remember, Munichika had lived the life of a warrior. Indeed, she takes a great pride in that. Yet, whenever she sees Fumidul, she can't help but compare herself to see the blatantly the depth of Fumidul's charms compared to her own. The world can be cruel sometimes. Yeah, well, I think you have some pretty good weapons there too. She can't help but mutter to herself as she prepares for their outing. I think you would have a fair chance as well, actually. Hey, event will occur. Depart for each location. Alright. We still have time. Alright. Office at night. Can probably understand what will happen there. Ruth's room at night. Night. Why does all of them have to be night? There's a lot happening in the night. You know what? Since both of these is the off... I just realized that both of these are the office. Interesting. Let's take Rute's room. Why not? Start with that. Yeah. I speak aloud in spite of myself, staring up at the night sky. With the elegant arc of the moon above for company, I gulp down the contents of my cup. Would you like another? Always there. I believe I would. Okay. Once Uru has filled my cup, I'll look back up to the moon, drinking in thoughts. Yeah, well. Before it came to violence. A little too late for that, I think, but bonked. Just as I'm considering another drink, I feel something bump into me from behind. Looking over, I see a small round eyes peering into my own with great interest. There she is. Are you by yourself, yeah? Hey! Everyone, yeah. We catch a cold, indeed. Yeah. Shinono's all warm, and her hair looks wet. She probably just came from the bath. Oh yeah, he works fast. Came.
Oh.
Well, as long as you don't mind. Okay. Then, from out of nowhere, I hear shattering voices nearby. Oh, is it all the girls? Is it all the girls? I peer across the hall and see the girls coming all this way, yep. Heat stroke, okay, yeah. Yeah, well, yeah. I can. Oh, everyone is free to join. Why not? Quite lively. Yeah. Wow. That's some intense talk in that case. Kuban fans herself with her hand. She seems she's a little overheated as well. Cannot drink as well. Oh. Okay. Wow. Good job. I have no idea what they pulled them from, but the twins start lining up more jugs nearby, each one full of booze. Oh, they do not answer, avoiding eye contact. Yeah, well, that's how devoted they are. Mm-hmm. Oh. She drinking, yep. Yeah, that. Ah. Yeah. I told you Nosuri knock back drink after drink, letting out sigh of satisfaction and making the kind of declaration you hear from drunk old men. Your cold tea is alright. Oh yeah, right, she's underage, so she's small, so.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. Tea while the others drinking sake. Sipping at the cold tea Rute supplied, Kuan and Nekone lets out a peaceful little sigh of their own.
Yay.
Hey, here you are. She prepared for everyone. Yay. Second best waifu. Yeah. In this game. You're welcome, indeed. Oh well. Well, well. Yep.
It's only sweet.
Oh. One must be mindful, okay? Mm-hmm. I realized whose voice that was and whirl around.
Yeah.
A big eater as always. Yeah. Okay. On my face, I think is the last one at least, but in this state, she projects absolutely no dignity as a princess. I can feel my temples aching. Facing Andrew properly, I straighten my posture and speak with the sternest tone I can manage. boring. Okay, well, I sigh inwardly, despairing at her whimsy. Considering everything Anju is, assassins could appear at any time and any place, I can't just let her do as she pleases. I don't think he will win this. I don't think he will win this at all. I can already feel a headache coming on at the prospect of conveying her, but another voice interrupts my thoughts. Kuan, yeah. Yeah, well, kinda true. Most of them probably, yes. I mean, all of them are girls, but they're not helpless. I feel quite relieved. Oh yeah, right, that's not my line. Anju puffs out her chest proudly. Mine, however, only puffs to accommodate another heavy sigh. Still, if having her here on her own would make things difficult, it'd be better to have her close to people we can trust. Yeah.
Okay.
Weren't they gonna be in the test? Oh no, this was the whole. No, they didn't take to the test room. Either way, she points accusingly to the empty plate. There used to be quite a lot on there, but not a single scrap remains. Can't be good for you. Okay, interesting. Have no sensitivity. Yeah, well. What is this gonna be? Kuon looks troubled as if something occurred to her. What is it now? What is it now? What is it your recommendation? Okay. What is it? What are we gonna hear now? Kuon replies with the utmost solemn dignity. Yes. A pool of full of hot water. Wow. I slump slightly sighing at this revelation. And you said so just earlier, okay? But didn't also they didn't have hot water? I thought they had like heat stroke. Weren't the warm water in the bath you took? Both mind and body at ease.
Okay.
Quite soothing as well. Oh, so it's the steam. Okay, steam bath. Alright. Yeah, of course it can be steam too. I didn't think of that. I didn't actually think of that. I was like, but you just took a bath. But yeah. Okay, all the best. and jump in, she did. Okay. She breaks eye contact, looking nonchalantly around the hallway. I suppose that's been erased from her memories. No. Yeah. It was nice in a few ways. Just say that we all want to have a big bath. Her eyes looks lighted and dreamy, like she's floating in one right now. Okay. And you nod vigorously at her words.
Yeah, warm. ゆらりゆらりと浮かぶ感じが。
Yeah, okay. The two of them clasped hands, lost in their respective yearning for the bath.
思考を誘導するな。
オストルだって湯船の方がいいと思わない？
お、
気持ちも分かんないでもないが。
そうじゃオストル、要は湯の風呂に入りたくなった。
See to it。
用意するのじゃ。
いえ、それが必要とあれば用意することやぶさかではありませんが。
Okay。
なぜじゃ、風呂など水を溜めて湯を沸かすだけであろう。
Some water and boil it。
この国では水そのものが希少でありますゆえ。
Yeah。
なんと。そうじゃったのか。いくつか水が貯められていた池があったのに。
Was being collected, yeah. To drink.
姫殿下、あれは生活のために貯められた水なのです。日常の生活に使う分しか確保できてないです。
さすがに。
But you have enough for steam baths? Isn't that like? I mean, the thing is that with hot water, but like, sure, you would have to like, it wouldn't be clean to drink.But I mean, isn't that... You can still use it as like water gardens and stuff like that after a while, so I mean... Essentially, it should be better than steam baths, but I'm not gonna argue against that. They probably have their reasons. Nekone chimes in, supporting our points. A new frowns, but almost immediately she puts her hands on her hips and she makes a proclamation.
仕方がないの。ならば我慢するほかないのじ
ゃ。
いや、断じて我慢などではないぞ。湯船に湯など張らずとも、ここの蒸し風呂で十分身も心もさっぱりなのじゃ。
And now Kuan is gonna be no.
大好きじゃ。
Traitor. Anyu hurriedly adds, nodding to herself.Even though her intent is obvious, the way in which she immediately dropped the idea inspires an odd pity. Naturally, if she wanted to invoke the power of her position, she could seize enough water to fill a bath for one or two people. But such extravagance under these circumstances would be unforgivable offense to the people. Anyu still has much to learn, but learn about matters of state, but she seems to grasp at least this much. Yeah.Kuon, meanwhile, while still understanding, lets out a deep sigh.
わかっていたけど、やっぱり水か。どこか。なあ、水が足りないとか何を言ってるんだ？
Is oh okay.
近くに豊富にあるはずだが。
Interesting, but I think we will end it here. I think we will end it here. It's a pretty good length, so yeah. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope my voice isn't too bad. I guess I will see when I check it through for to see if there are any problems with the video, but there usually isn't. But I hope my voice isn't that bad. And again, sorry for not being able to upload on Saturday, yesterday. So, but I hope you enjoyed this video, and until next time, be cool.